सो नेक्स्ट वन इज़ द लेंथ ऑफ पाथ ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट. सो आर यू इज इक्वल टू रेडियस ऑफ और ये स्मॉल आर. सो वो वन एल इक्वल रेडियस ऑफ वैडेडम सर्कल ऑफ फिनिन. सो कैपिटल आर यू इज इक्वल टू वो टू के रेडियस ऑफ वैडेडम सर्कल ऑफ व्हील. देन आर बी इज इक्वल टू ओ वन पी इज इक्वल टू रेडियस ऑफ व्हील सर्कल ऑफ फिनियन. आर इज इक्वल टू ओ टू पी रेडियस ऑफ व्हील सर्कल ऑफ द व्हील. लेंथ ऑफ पाथ ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट वी फाइंड रेडियस ऑफ द बेस सर्कल ऑफ फिनियन ओ वन एम इज इक्वल टू ओ वन पी कॉस फाइव इज इक्वल टू आर कॉस फाइव. And radius of this base circle of wheel O to N is equal to O to P cos phi is equal to R cos phi. Now friend right angled triangle O to KN. KN is equal to O to K whole square minus O to N whole square is equal to R A square minus R square cos square phi. PN is equal to P to O to P sin phi is equal to R sin phi. The length of the path of the length of part of the path of contact or the path of approach. So KP is equal to KN minus PN is equal to root of RA square minus R square cos square pi minus R sin pi. Similarly, from right angled triangle O1ML, so ML is equal to O1L whole square minus O2 m whole square is equal to r a square minus r square cos square pi. So m p is equal to o to p sin pi is equal to r sin pi. Length of path of contact is equal to continue. The length of part of the path of contact or path of approach k p is equal to k n minus p n is equal to r a square minus r square cos square pi minus r cos pi. Similarly, from right angled triangle O1ML, ML is equal to O1L whole square minus O1M whole square, RA square minus R square cos square pi. So MP is equal to O1P sin phi is equal to R sin phi. The length of part of the path of contact or path of reaches PL is equal to ML minus MP. Root of R A square minus R square cos square pi minus R sin pi. The length of path of contact KL is equal to KP plus PL is equal to R A square minus R square cos square pi plus small R A square minus R square cos square pi minus capital R plus small r into sin pi. Contact ratio or number of pairs of teeth in contact. The contact ratio or number of pair of teeth in contact is defined as the ratio of the length of arc of contact to the circular pitch. Mathematically, contact ratio or number of pairs of teeth in contact, the length of the arc of contact per P. So P is a circular pitch and M is a module. So this is the problem from which we need to find out the addendum. So the sum given here is the number of teeth on each of the two equal spur gears in mesh are 40. The teeth have 20 degree involute profile and the module is 6 mm. Arc of contact is 1.152 to the circular pitch. Find the addendum. So these are the things given. We know circular pitch is equal to pi into m, where we get the solution 18.85 mm. Length of arc of contact is equal to, it specified 1.75 times. So 1.75 into pc is equal to 33 mm, and length of path of contact is equal to length of arc of contact into cos pi. So RA, capital RA, capital R, smaller radius of addendum circle of each wheel. So R is equal to, small r is equal to MT by 2, that is equal to 120 mm. length of path of contact, that is RA, that is addendum RA is equal to 126.12, from which we can calculate the addendum of the wheel. R is equal to 6.12 mm. So this is the next sum given here. A pair of gears having 40 and 20 teeth respectively are rotating in mesh. The speed of the smaller being 2000 rpm. Determine the velocity of sliding between the gear teeth faces at the point of engagement at the pitch point. And at the point of disengagement, if the smaller gear is the driver, assuming the gear teeth are 20 degree. Involute form addendum length is 5 mm and the module is 5 mm. Find the angle through which pinion turns while any pairs of teeth are in contact. That should be measured. Angular velocity of the smaller gear is omega 1 is equal to 2 pi n by 60, from which we can calculate the angular velocity 209.5 radian per second. Then angular velocity of larger V gear W2 is equal to W1 into T by T, from which we can calculate 104.75 radian per second. Pitch circle radius of the smaller gear, so R is equal to MT by 2, from which we can calculate the value of 50 mm. PCD of larger gear, MT by 2 is equal to 100 mm. Radius of addendum circle of smaller gear, so R is equal to R plus addendum, so 50 plus 5 is equal to 5 mm, 55 mm. Radius of addendum circle of large gear, so R is equal to R plus addendum, 100 plus 5, 105 mm. So we know the distance of point of engagement K from the pitch point P, or the length of the path of contact. So KP is equal to RA whole square minus R square cos square pi minus R sin pi. So that's equal to root of 105 whole square minus 100 square cos square 20 degree minus 100 sin 20 degree. So 46.85 minus 34.2 is equal to 12.65 mm. The distance of pitch point P from the point of disengagement L, or the length of the path of recess, is equal to RA whole square minus R square cos square pi minus R sin pi. So root of 55 square minus 50 square cos square 20 degree minus 50 sin 20 degree is equal to 28.6 minus 17.1 is equal to 11.5. So velocity of sliding at the point of engagement is equal to omega 1 plus omega 2 into Kp is equal to 3975 mm per second. Velocity of sliding at the pitch point. Since the velocity of sliding is proportional to the distance of the contact point from the pitch point, therefore the velocity of sliding at the pitch point is zero. Velocity of sliding at the point of disengagement. You know, the velocity of sliding at the point of engagement, L is equal to omega 1 plus omega 2 PL is equal to 3614 mm per second. Angle through which pinion turns, so KL is equal to KP plus PL is equal to 24.15. Length of arc of contact, KL is equal divided by cos phi. So 24.15 divided by cos 20 is equal to 25.7. The circumference of the smaller gear or pinion, that is equal to 2 pi r, from which we can calculate the value of 314.2 mm. The angle through which pinion turns, length of arc of contact into 360 divided by circumference of the pinion, so from which we can calculate the value of 29.45 degree.